all of the science, which is uncontroverted, points to the fact that 16 and 17-year-olds do not have the brain capacity and the judgment that an adult does. And yet we're treating them as adults in a system that is very unforgiving.
When I was 16, I didn't think about it. I just did it. It was like, it seemed cool, so let's do it. So, you know, and then afterwards, when you're sitting in a cell, you start thinking about, wow, this is what's happening. This is what I did. This is what I'm going to jail for.
There's a lot of restrictions that these young people cannot have, but we're saying, not only are we going to treat them as adults in terms of the court system and prosecution, but we're going to place them in adult facilities. And what we say is, when you do that, not only are you saying we want these young people to be held accountable, we're saying that we want these young people to be abused and traumatized.
How do you rationalize how a kid should be in that kind of facility? Especially when you press them on the issue of the strong opponents, and the core of it is, well, we will be perceived as soft on crime. But if you want to do what's right, you stand up.
Public safety increases by raising the age of criminal responsibility, because providing young people with the kinds of treatment and counseling and trauma-informed therapy that is required helps them to return to the society without the same challenges that brought them in contact with the criminal justice system initially.
48 states in this country have seen the light and have changed their system, with benefits to both the individual offender and the system and the communities.
In other states, such as Connecticut, where the age of criminal responsibility was raised, there was no uptick in the crime rate. In fact, the arrest rates went down. They plummeted. And we expect that the same will happen in New York. It's time for us to get smart on crime.